Hello, hello. It is another day of box office predictions and another day of Dewey likely wrecking the set, but it's okay because we have a lot to celebrate in Fantasy Movie League this week. As you guys might know, I've been slacking a little. I keep forgetting to set my lineup, but I said it last week and I did it. I wanted to get back in the mix, and we had 60 perfect lineups in the league last week, and I was one of them. Here are all the names up on the screen. I just got to keep talking so you get a moment to soak all of these in. I'm in the mix somewhere here. Apparently, everybody knew that yesterday was going to be a bit of a smash hit and come in way above expectations because look at all these perfect lineups. All right, I am so happy that I wound up on that list because my predictions for my top five weren't all that spot on, but if I'm being honest with you guys, I did have a lot of fun taking a couple of big swings. Of course, we had Toy Story 4 topping the charts, but dropping a little more than I expected. It dipped about 50% in weekend two and made another $59.7 million. Then it was Annabelle Comes Home, which I'm kind of bummed about. It did make a total of $31 million over the five-day release, but for the three-day weekend, it only posted $20.3 million, a low for the Conjuring franchise. On the bright side, though, again, yesterday it overperformed, topping what I thought was an already high number of $12 million and kicking off its run with a very solid $17 million. And then Aladdin yet again saw a very minimal drop, just 23.6%, letting it take another $10.1 million. And then finally, at number five, it wasn't Avengers Endgame, but rather The Secret Life of Pets 2, which enjoyed a strong hold and made another $7.3 million. As for the Avengers Endgame re-release, I was kind of on track because the movie did make more than many had projected, but I went way too high with that $9 million pick, and it wound up making $6.1 million over the weekend. Now going into the new round, of course, it's a holiday weekend ahead of us. Just know that my final predictions that you're going to see in the summary at the end of this video, it is for the three-day run. I will briefly discuss some five and even six-day totals, but the official predictions are for the three-day runs. And now, kicking it off, I kind of don't want to underestimate Aladdin again, but in my mind right now, I'm thinking even if it holds on to 70% of last weekend's profits, I still think that Midsommar is going to have a strong enough opening to top it, which is why at number five, I have newcomer Midsommar. All right, I've said Midsommar once, I'm going to say it properly now, Midsommar. So with this one, I have a feeling that A24 has high hopes that it's going to repeat Hereditary's business. So when that movie came out, Ari Aster's first feature film as a director, that movie opened to a whopping $13.5 million. But I don't think that's going to happen with Midsommar. Instead, looking at some other A24 releases, I've got my eye on The Witch and then also It Comes at Night. And I'm thinking that Midsommar might fall right in between the two of them. The Witch opened up with about $8.8 million, and then It Comes at Night took $6 million. So if I come in the middle of those two, I am at roughly $7.5 million for Midsommar's three-day opening weekend run. Now it's on to the number four spot, and that is where I have Annabelle Comes Home. After that movie disappointed at the box office last weekend, I have a feeling it could be heading down a very similar path to The Curse of La Llorona, which dropped a whopping 70% its second weekend in theaters. But before I get too carried away there, I do have to consider the fact that weekend two of La Llorona, that's when Avengers Endgame came out, and it basically sucked all the air and all the money out of the room for every other movie in play. So I don't think the fall is going to be that drastic, but I do think that something like a 60% drop for this movie is inevitable given how things kicked off and also the cinema score. So if I lock in a 60% drop, that means that Annabelle Comes Home is making $8 million for the three-day weekend, and then I'll go with $12 million for the full five-day run. That brings us to the number three position now, and that's where I have last weekend's big surprise. It's Yesterday. I did have a good feeling about this one last weekend, but now that it overperformed, I have an even better feeling about it this time around. And I know these are very different movies, but I'm briefly looking at the movie night and day because of how profits were divvied up its opening weekend and also the fact that weekend two was a holiday for that one. So if I look at weekend two of that one's run, after it kicked off its start with $20 million, it fell 48%. The thing is, though, I have a feeling that Yesterday is going to benefit from even more good word of mouth and also the higher cinema score. So if I take that percent change, lower it to something like 45%, we have a 3-day total of $10 million for Yesterday and then a full 5-day run of about $15 million. All right, creeping up the charts now at number 2, we've got Toy Story 4. And with this one, there is no better comp to go with than Toy Story 3. Both movies hit theaters right around the same time of year, and then weekend 3 of its run, Toy Story 3, also fell on the 4th of July holiday. So with that in mind, plus the fact that weekend 2, both movies made a very similar amount, $59 million, I'm thinking that this could be a repeat of Toy Story 3 weekend 3 percent change, especially considering that movie in weekend 3 was going up against the openings of the Twilight Saga Eclipse and also The Last Airbender. And if you combine the amount of money that those two made, I think it could be somewhat comparable to what Far From Home might make this week. And so I'm going to go ahead and take Toy Story 3's weekend 3% change of 49% and just apply it right to Toy Story 4, which would give me about $30 million for the 3-day run and then roughly $43 million for the full 5-day weekend. All right, guys, now it's time for the big one. The number one movie on my list this weekend, of course, is Spider-Man Far From Home. And I should probably say right up top with this one that it's going to be a little difficult to predict. I feel like the longer weekends always make hitting that right number even more difficult. But with this particular holiday, we have to factor in so many things, some of which I'll get to in this analysis here, but things like weather, are people going to go out on the 4th of July holiday to see movies, or are they going to do other activities? What about the travel days? How is that going to impact the box office? So many things happening here. But in order to parse through this all, I'm at least going to start with Spider-Man Homecoming. That movie opened up in 2017 and it made $117 million opening weekend. I do think it got an added boost because it was the first Spider-Man movie in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. And on top of that, I also think it had greater opportunity to make more money given what the release calendar looked like, because we've seen the effects of Avengers Endgame's phenomenal performance on so many other big studio releases, and it has taken some of the money for other movies out of the equation. However, in Far From Home's case, Endgame could also wind up helping it out because this is the first movie we're getting after the events of Endgame in the MCU. Curiosity for the story is just so high right now. Sony apparently is running with the projections of $125 million for the full 6-day stretch, which seems so low to me right now, but there's other projections out there, industry projections, that have a range of $170 to $190 million for 6 days. That seems much more likely, especially when you take The Amazing Spider-Man into account. That movie also had a 6-day run July 4th weekend, and for 6 days, it made $137 million, and then just for the 3-day run, it made $62 million. This movie absolutely has to top those numbers. With the popularity of the MCU, the really great reviews this one's getting, I'm kind of liking a number right in the middle of that range that I mentioned before, and I think I want to settle on something like $180 million for this movie's full 6-day run. And if I use Amazing Spider-Man's numbers as an example and I try to divvy up the money in a similar way, that leaves me with a total of $85 million for Spider-Man Far From Home's 3-day weekend in theaters. All right, guys, it's time for that recap. But again, a reminder, these are 3-day totals I'm giving you right now. Spider-Man Far From Home coming out on top with $85 million. Then it's Toy Story 4 at number 2 with $30 million. Yesterday taking the 3 position with $10 million. Then it's Annabelle comes home at number 4 with $8 million. And then finally, Midsommar taking the 5 spot with $7.5 million this weekend. All right, guys, you know what to do now. Hit the comment section below. And I really want to know 2 things from you. What do you think about Far From Home's chances? Are your numbers higher or lower than mine? And also, what about Midsommar? Is there any chance it really is going to top Aladdin this weekend for that 5 spot? Or am I giving it too much credit? Chime in the comments below. And don't forget to lock those Fantasy Movie League lineups. Big weekend this weekend. Spider-Man Far From Home is divided up for Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, so keep that in mind. And now, before I say goodbye, we've got some Patreon shoutouts, and this is for a whole group that's on the shoutout tier of the campaign, and they are Charles, Craig, Paul, Andrew, Corey, and Jefferson. A whole bunch of very familiar names right there that I am proud to have as longtime members of this campaign. So guys, yet again, thank you so much for the continued support, and thanks to everybody out there for watching this video. Please don't forget to like and share, and I'll see you next weekend to see how we all did on our box office predictions.